Early Riser, Johnny Vaughn. Funny Lady, Sarah Milliken. And their team captain, Sean Locke. And facing them tonight, Pineapple Dancer, Louis Spence. Swindon's Funniest, John Richardson. And their team captain, Jason Manford. Now, welcome your host, Jimmy Carr.
Hello, and welcome to 8 out of 10 Cats, a show about opinion polls, surveys, and statistics. Did you know, for example, 45% of couples would like to be more adventurous in the bedroom? You might like to try lights on, socks off. 62% of people believe in fate. I suppose if you don't believe in fate, that's just the way it was meant to be. More germs are transferred when shaking hands than kissing. So, don't touch it, love. And 58% of women think chocolate is the biggest temptation on a diet, whereas actually, it's the temptation to buy leggings, which are clearly two sizes too small. Right, let's get started. What are you talking about? That's the name of our first round. We've teamed up with a leading polling organisation and they've asked the British nation what stories they've been discussing this week. It's our panellist's job to guess the British public's top five most popular talking points. Jason. Louis, John, what do you think the nation have been talking about this week?
Do you reckon, Louis, what you've been talking about this week, mate?
Oh, I don't think you want to know what I've been talking about, but...
we literally do.
No, OK, yeah. I don't know. Pope?
Oh, yeah, the Pope.
Pope?
He was in and he went. I miss him already, I'll be honest with you. I was enjoying the Pope being here. I feel like everyone had a go at him all week and now I think, oh, I miss him now he's gone. You know what I mean?
What do you miss about him? Having to watch him just go about on his holidays?
Yeah.
On every channel, just going... It was so boring. On BBC News, I switched over and the woman was going, well, the one thing that struck me about the Pope's visit is everything's been very much on schedule. Is, you know, all bit, gays are evil and condoms spread AIDS, but when the Pope says 7:30, he is there. 7:30.
Did you enjoy the papal visit over this side?
Yeah, it's good. He had some nice, good pink slippers and stuff. I like that. And it did make me think at the time, you know, the wealth around him. I thought, that's so like Jesus, isn't it? I suddenly thought, what private jet would Jesus fly? That's right on the Christian message. I also noticed that whenever they were showing kind of montage of him growing up, he just went from baby to man. Because you can't show the bit in the middle because he was a Nazi.
I think you could show pictures of the Pope as a teenager when he was a Nazi, because all you've got to do is cover up the swastika, yeah, and then you could just go, oh, there he is as a teenager, always high-fiving.
Yeah. There's one point we kept playing this shot of these 3,000 kids meeting all these priests.
Oh, I saw that. It was in, yeah, Twickenham or something, wasn't
and
it?
And I just thought, who did the risk assessment there?
He met up with five victims of abuse, though, didn't he, of child abuse?
That was just a coincidence.
Well, I thought, I
one of those things, occasionally you find yourself in a room with five victims, and you go, this is weird.
Well, I just thought he looked a bit like boot camp on X Factor, like they'd whittled it down to the top five. They got to pick the best one.
Did you read about Colleen Rooney as well? Colleen Rooney wanted to meet the Pope. She wanted to meet the Pope to have a chat with him about Wayne Rooney. Think that the last thing this 83-year-old German man who's come all this way wants to hear is her, like, rocking, all right, there, Pope, can I have a chat to you about that Wayne? He's been nobbing a prosy and just love him. I love him and I want to take him back, but I don't know, can you have a word with Jesus or Moses or whatever?
It's like she's in the room.
It's weird, isn't it? I know. And now I'm me.
What I don't understand about the Pope is this, is that he's very much against condoms and the use of condoms. But the Catholic Church is based on the teachings of Jesus, right? And there's no mention of condoms in the Bible.
No.
They weren't invented then. So why has he got an opinion on something that wasn't invented then?
Does he have a problem if he used them as water balloons?
He doesn't think stuff through, Sarah. No. He just goes, yeah, no, you can't
use
them.
He's killing all the fun in the world, isn't he?
What about if you just pull it over your head and blow it up your nose? Hilarious at a team.
Nobody party does that but you, Jimmy.
Well, I still haven't got anyone pregnant, so it does work. Well, let's have a look and see whether the Pope is one of the most talked about things this week. Yes, the Pope has left Britain after a four-day visit. The Pope apologised for all the paedophilic priests. When Jesus said, suffer little children to come unto me, I'm pretty sure he didn't mean like that. Sean, Johnny, so what else have the nation been talking about?
The Commonwealth Games isn't ready. The site isn't ready yet. Oh, no. They haven't finished it.
It's where everyone's kind of amazed about the fact that the games are a bit of a mess and the accommodation isn't good. And yeah, they haven't put the money in. But whatever the athletes' accommodation is like, you know, most of the population would move in pretty fucking gladly.
It does seem odd that sort of downtown Delhi, and the big problem is we haven't finished the velodrome.
Yes. The ceiling has collapsed in the weight training room. And I was just thinking to myself, this is a real problem. I was thinking, well, just bring it into the competition. Just get the weight trainers in there to hold it up. And it's like last man standing. Great big chunky thigh guy. I said, I can take it, I'm out. And he's just left with one big thighed, like, guy from Nigeria just to hold it up.
What I don't understand is the first of our athletes to say that it wasn't going was Philip Sadowu, who's a triple jumper, whose event is basically jumping in sand, which is the one thing you can definitely do on a building site.
I think the opening ceremony would be good. I think it would be like something like, and there's two diggers there reversing over there. And don't the athletes look marvellous in their high visibility jackets? They're really representing all that's wonderful about modern India. Oh, and there's a forklift lifting a pallet there.
It does look pretty bad. Have you seen the pictures of it?
I mean,
it looks extreme. It looks like the set from Hostel 3. Have a look. Have a little look. Oh. That is, I mean,
there's no toilet roll.
And the next one, go and have a look. That's.
To be fair, it's not finished.
Well, no, that's worse than you think. That's the pool.
We've all done that in a shower, haven't we?
When they phoned up to complain about the conditions, they actually got through to a call centre in England.
We're going to see if it's one of the most talked about things this week, the Commonwealth Games. Yes, the Commonwealth Games in Delhi are in crisis. The organisers in Delhi said that Westerners just have different standards of cleanliness. We've also got different standards of roof collapsiness and bridge not fully downiness. Good. Right, OK, well, that's two things. Back over to your team, Jason. Yep. What else have the nation been talking about? John?
Well, allegedly...
Of course.
Allegedly, Jason. David Beckham, apparently, has paid £1,500 for a lesbian romp. Which I love the word.
Well, you can't have a lesbian romp if you're a man as well, so that's clearly made up.
Lesbian romp, though, makes me think that he gets the two lesbians to dress up as Henry VIII.
We should say, David Beckham's absolutely refuted
apparently,
and he's taking them to court. He didn't do it.
Furious.
I'd be like seeing David Beckham.
Furious. I'm furious. Oh.
His spokesman said he was furious but calm. Yeah. It sounds like a little bit like Frank Spencer.
It does seem odd that they've reported it in the papers. They've reported that it isn't true, basically, in the tabloids, which they get to kind of have their cake and eat it because they've basically made it a front-page story going, yeah, he never did this. And you go, right, so your story is...
He never did something.
He never did nothing.
So what are we doing here, then? We're doing the same thing, right?
Exactly the same thing.
I'll tell you why I don't believe it. It's because he's the most famous man on the planet.
Right.
He'd be less conspicuous having sex with her in a shopping trolley in Sainsbury's, wouldn't he?
Didn't stop Tiger Woods, did it? It's not like Tiger Woods is going, nobody knows it's me, I'm wearing a hat.
He said it was all malicious lies. He doesn't know the word malicious, does he? He just said, sorry, Posh, I didn't do it. I like the fact that he might call her Posh at home.
I think he does.
I was there at dinner, he does.
Were you there at dinner?
I've been to dinner, yeah.
Hold on. We've all been to dinner. Have you been to dinner at the Beckham's house?
I've been twice to Beckham Palace, darling. I was some Spice Girls tour. I know them. We're old friends. David wouldn't do that. I'm sorry. It's not in his nature.
It's weird, though, isn't it? Because everyone, after the Wayne Rooney thing, everyone was very supportive of Colleen, but people don't seem to like Victoria Beckham. I don't know what people's problems with her. Every time I've seen her interviewed, you know, she seems quite a pleasant girl, but every time I speak to people about her, they don't like it. It's like, did I miss the day when she put a cat in the bin or something? What's going on?
You like her, Lou?
I like her. She's lovely. She's nice. Yeah. She's an Aries like me. She's very funny.
I was about to say that.
She'd be good on this show. She's got a quick humour. She's very good. She's very funny.
Why does she hide that? What are you saying? It's
Let's have a look and see whether David Beckham is one of the most talked about things this week. David Beckham has denied that he slept with two prostitutes in 2007 and is threatening legal action. It just doesn't make sense. I mean, if David Beckham liked two women at the same time, why did he marry a half? Sean, Johnny, Sarah, what else have the nation been talking about this week?
The Liberal Democratic Conference. They've had a conference, haven't they, this week? All those Liberal Democrat party members are watching Nick Clegg and they all must be thinking the same thing. He goes, they must be thinking, you've moved in with that bloke you used to shout at. You used to hate him, you used to publicly attack him, and now you're living together.
It's mental how well they're getting on, him and David Cameron. Have you read? I was reading yesterday about that they keep sending texts to each other. Like, oh, just closed another hospital, LOL, or whatever, you know.
But then also, it emerged that, that David Cameron and Nick Clegg assemble IKEA furniture together. Is that... I don't know, I just heard that. I like the idea, because they've said they both have trouble with IKEA furniture.
Oh, they're gay.
And I think, is that...
They're having trouble with it. I mean, we buy it, but we don't put it together.
It's a sign of just how tedious it all is, that that's like a news story, that two men put up a cupboard. And then there's Clegg and Cameron as well, and then Miliband is going to be one of them. You see, the three of them are just the most tedious. It's like coming down for breakfast and they're going, what do you want for breakfast? Do you want shredded wheat, all bran or Weetabix? I'd rather kill myself. It comes to something when you want, like, Ed Balls to win the Labour leadership just because at least he's a bit fat.
Not just because of that, his surname is Balls.
Oh, Balls. Yeah. This is true.
And his first name's Head. But Ed, isn't it? So he's got a name which is two parts of the human body. I wonder what his middle name is. Knee. Ed Knee Balls.
Ed Knee Dim Balls.
Knees and Balls.
Knees and Balls.
Go on, do the bendy bit.
Knees and Balls and Balls. Knees and Balls.
One thing I noticed about the conference, just saying this, is you know that politicians, you know when they used to make speeches and they used to make a point, they used to do this. And none of them do this. They all do this horrible thing now with their sort of thumb and their bent finger. They go like this, they go, like they've lost a wand or something. That's how they make a point now, isn't it? They go, and another thing, because people don't like being pointed at, do they?
It's very aggressive. It's the most aggressive human gesture. It's literally channeling.
What about this?
No, it's
that is scarier than being pointed at, definitely.
Is it? Yeah.
I don't know if it's just your face or if it was the expression.
Nice. Let's have a look and see whether the Lib Dem party conference is one of the most talked about things this week. Yes, the Lib Dem party conference took place this week. They have one every year. Who knew? Nick Clegg pointed out that being Deputy Prime Minister is a big job. Quite right. David Cameron's cock isn't going to suck itself. Right, fingers on buzzers. One thing to get. Go on.
Is it the Pakistani cricketers?
Well, I didn't know we had that.
Yeah.
They're connected. Do it again.
I know what I'm getting you for Christmas.
OK. The cricket... Well, this is more generally. It's sort of the cricketing scandal this
week. So it started off with the Pakistani cricketers. Now the English cricketers are being accused of it. I mean, it's made cricket interesting, at least, hasn't it?
Yeah. The shocking news that cricket, you can kind of tell what's going to happen because they're watching an over with the people and they're starting to tell you what's going to happen, which is interesting because I can tell you what's going to happen in over cricket, which is pretty much fuck all.
Is it match-fixing essentially being intentionally rubbish at something? I was match-fixing in netball for years at PE.
No, what it is, what they do is it's spread betting. They don't fix the actual result of the game, but what they do is people do spread betting, so they'll bet on the amount of, for example, no balls in a certain over.
Yeah,
and I've betted on no balls in a bar in Thailand. We're going, I don't think she's got balls. Anyone now who bets on cricket's an idiot because it's totally fixed. There's only and so many sports are fixed these days. The only sport you can't fix is pigeon racing.
can't bribe pigeons.
You can actually. You can
they're too competitive.
They have fixed them. They have fixed them. Other pigeon fanciers have got hawks in the air that will take a rival's pigeons down. It's been a big...
Yeah, but that's not the pigeons.
It's been a pretty big bloody scandal that's rocked my fucking world.
Is it? You can't bribe pigeons. And
wrong.
That's my last... That's, those are my last
they
words when I die. But I'm going to go...
Greedy little
bastards.
Can't
bribe pigeons!
Have you tried?
To bribe a pigeon?
Yeah. What did you do?
I tried to get it nearer so I could hit it with something, yeah.
And let's have a look and see whether the cricketing scandal is one of the most talked about things this Ooh. Week. So those were the most talked about stories this week. But in other news, Mary Bale, the cat in the bin lady, has been charged with animal cruelty. I'll tell you how evil she is. I don't even call her the cat in the bin lady. I call her Osama bin lady. Experts say a solar flare due to occur in 2013 could wipe out life on planet Earth. The solar flare could be so powerful that some girls in Liverpool will finally go the colour they want. And George Michael has been moved to a softer prison. George is now spending up to 23 hours a day in his cellmate. At the end of that round, Sean, Johnny and Sarah have 2 points, Jason, Louis and John have 3 points. Join me after the break when we'll be finding out the best way to seduce a lady. Welcome back to 8 out of 10 Cats. Our next round is Pick of the Polls. Jason, you're to go first. What do you like the look of?
I think it seems a shame not to go for this Vetriano Prince. It
looks like an Argentinian tango to me.
OK, you've chosen the man and woman dancing. Take a look at this.
And let me tell you, I got a very special guest this time. His name is Rick, and where are you from, Rick?
Arizona.
Arizona. He's been a member for of Hedonism 2 for how many years again?
Since 1988.
How many times you say you've been here?
40 times.
40 times. What brings you to Hedonism that many times?
The wild women. The wild women. The ripping and the tearing. The ripping and the tearing.
That's what I'm talking about. That's what I'm talking about. Oh, my goodness. So what have you done this whole entire week?
There's no other place in this universe like Hedonism, too.
None. You hear that? Do your dance.
What do you think? How would you rate your dancing?
It didn't quite have the action going on. It didn't have enough of a, like, pulse going on there through it.
Enough of a pulse going on.
I mean,
you could do that better than that.
Oh, hello.
I don't know if it would it be appropriate for me to break up with my girlfriend now?
John's turn.
How optimistic are our production team that they went? Yeah. Start the music again. I imagine Sean will be up there like a shot. You know what he's like with a pump and grind.
Can you get both legs over your shoulders?
I'll just ask him out. But... Now, the question... There is a question related to this, OK? Most men think dancing is the most effective form of seduction. Is that true or false?
Well... If it hasn't just been proved to me right here in this room. When I dance, it's more of a statement
And that statement is, Jason's had a Bailey's.
Very good. It depends on the location, doesn't it? I mean, in a club and that's fine. In a restaurant, you're better off complimenting her eyes rather than doing the Macarena. Like, you know.
Catch them off guard, though. They'll be expecting you to dance in a nightclub.
Or like at work. Sheila, have you got those accounts?
That was a very good dance.
I was making some lunch the other week and a song came on. I danced so violently during the song that I was too nauseous to eat my lunch.
I injured myself once dancing. I was at a wedding and I invented the skipping rope dance. You might have known. It swept the nation in about 99. And I did a skipping rope dance. And
that one, where you cross it.
No, there's no skipping rope involved. It's an imaginary skipping rope.
I thought you were just jumping.
He didn't have a real one.
You'd get somebody else, and they'd hold the end of the imaginary skipping rope, and then both of you would do that, and then everyone would come in the middle, and they'd do, like, dances.
Start again.
Right, so... For example,
we can do it.
You take the skipping rope and go over there, right? You go over there. You've got a skipping rope. No, let go, darling. Imagine we've got a skipping rope now, and you're
in the way.
It's fine. So we'll do this.
Well, and then I'm here.
Yeah. So do this.
Right, hold on.
You ready? Right. And then you got to clap and then do all that. Collab, right. Then you go.
Yeah. Throw some moves. You've got to throw some moves as well.
Yeah.
I'm not quite. I think Louis would really be the skipping rope person there. You invented that.
I invented that. So, yeah. See, he knows what to do.
I can't dance with an erection.
That's not a nice thing to call him.
I did! I won't!
It's not dance I invented. What? The hammer dance. You know, like the hammer, where you just go...
Yes. Oh, the hammer.
No, you're like MC Hammer.
I invented that. You know when you're in a disco and you go...
We'd better be
I invented that. Well, I spent about 10 minutes beforehand going...
Yeah.
Discus.
Would you do it with a rib rotation, though, or would it just be on its own?
I'm usually quite pissed, Louis.
A rib rotation?
Yeah, but would it be... like that with the hammer, or is it just the hammer?
Just sort of go like that.
Oh, right. Oh, the butch hammer.
Do the noise as well, like...
The release noise. Give them the noise when you release. So.
Soup!
And always, when I used to DJ, I used to drop the sound just for that. When I used to go... Soup! Let's just bring it back up. So give me the night. And something like that.
Brilliant. So what do you think? Most men think dancing is the most effective form of seduction. True or false?
Well, you're a dancer. You're the best person to say.
We'll sit on
I think false. I think most men look like wankers when they dance.
do you think that's true? Do you think men think it's the most effective form of seduction?
Yes, because I don't think they're right, but I think that they think
you
that.
You think it's true. OK, right, you're going false. OK, I can tell you the answer is false.
Oh no, we gambled.
Only 26% of men think dancing is the most effective form of seduction. Women love to dance with men because instinctively they know if they dance with a man, they'll be able to tell what he's like in the bedroom. And it is a good indicator. I tend to dance for about 30 seconds, then have a bit of a cry.
It's not a joke, is it?
No, not a joke.
No, it's not a joke.
That's what I said.
Sean, Johnny and Sarah, what do you like the look of?
Oh, the dog.
Come here, Sarah, come on.
The dog, OK, you've chosen the dog. Take a look at this.
He was born Gary Matthews, but for most of his 44 years, this Green Tree man hasn't acted or dressed like a human. Instead, he's taken on the persona of a dog. His house filled with dog movies, books, and toys.
I bark, and sometimes, you know, I just, you know...
Gary says he feels most comfortable dressing in this costume, which he's been wearing to furry animal conventions for years. The unemployed computer technician even walks through his neighborhood, not as Gary, but as Boomer. Do you consider yourself to be more of a dog or a human being?
Well, I guess in spirit, more of a dog.
Boomer the dog there. I think I know how that guy has sex. On his own.
Why has he got a dog suit, though, made of paper? Why not just get a furry one, like dogs
or made of
dogs?
Well, he's an office worker, isn't he? So he's obviously gone to the shredder and gone, I'll just use this shit.
OK, here is your related question. 27% of people have an obsession that they're embarrassed to admit to. True or false?
True.
I think it's false. I would have said much higher.
Yeah, I'd have said higher.
Yeah. Well, obsession. Obsession is quite serious, isn't it?
Yeah, an obsession is something. It's something not... like that.
Oh right. Okay. In that case, no.
What's your obsession, Johnny?
Starting collections, I think.
Starting collections. It's not just actually collecting. What was the last collection you started?
I don't know. I bought about 4 penknives. They're there. Oh, I bought my daughter like 4 snow shakers. That's a bit of a click. We're going no further.
When I'm stressed. Oh, we do. Oh, we're not all doing our obsessions.
Yeah, go on. Obsessions.
When I'm stressed, I buy baby clothes.
Well, just the way you said that doesn't make you sound at all like the most mental woman that's ever lived. Baby clothes.
The last time I bought a little pair of plimsolls, the lady said, "Do you want a gift receipt?" And I said, "No. Pretty sure they're gonna fit."
The imaginary baby.
Oh no, I don't know. I don't like kids.
What do you do?
Not a freak.
So why do you buy the baby clothes?
Just because they're so canny. They make me happy. I've only got 2 things. I haven't got a collection yet.
Isn't that a bit weird for people visiting your house?
They're not on the wall. They're not in my wardrobe, like size 18,
she lives
size
in a doll's 18, house.
18 months. Oh. Now, one day I'm gonna train a cat to wear them, probably.
When you say train a cat, you mean train a cat to put them on?
Yeah, exactly. I don't want to force it.
No, well, you're not. I thought it
was... Just every day he sees the little top there and eventually just goes, I'll try it on.
It's just curiosity, isn't it?
It's nice wearing clothes there too. I sometimes, if I...
Uh-oh.
If I, you know, I'm a bit... sensitive, mm-hmm. I will wear a T-shirt that's a bit too small for me because it feels like you're getting a cuddle.
What a proper
copy. Oh, it's a beautiful thing.
Oh, literally, there isn't a girl in this room that won't sleep with you now.
Sean, do you have an obsession?
I've collected a number of things in my life. I used to collect ales, but it turned out my collection was worthless because I drank them all. But I collect butterflies as well. Oh. I collect butterflies. And one of them about collecting butterflies is you spend hours just admiring the delicate structure of their wings. Oh. And then I used to roll them into a ball and put them in my pocket. Because I wanted to have my collection with me, always.
Do you know what I love collecting? DNA.
Yes!
I've only got about 360 bits. You know, I wouldn't call it a database.
And you start.
I'll just like where Sarah's been sitting there, I was having that. I'll just click a little swab of that.
A bit of my boyfriend from under there.
Yes. Just bits of hair and stuff.
The only thing I don't commit to really is sometimes I race with strangers. I don't tell them, but just you know, like I'll see someone walking and I think I can beat them to the lamppost.
27% of people have an obsession that they're embarrassed to admit to. True or false?
I was so adamant, and then you... I don't know. No. Now we...
False.
He's talked about
false.
It, and he's...
going false. False.
So everyone here has.
OK, so you're going false. What are you going to go, Jason?
We're going to go true, then. John's
OK, I can tell you the answer is false. Yes, only 12% of people have an obsession that they're too embarrassed to admit to. People do get obsessive. I had a stalker once. Literally everywhere I went, there she was, 20 metres ahead. Eventually, I had to hide in a tree outside her house just to get away from her.
I was a stalker for a while.
Were you?
I stalked people for a bit, yeah. Sorry, carry on with that.
So at the end of that round, it's 3 points for Sean's team and 4 points for Jason's team. Join us after the break when we'll be finding out the most common cause of arguments. To 8 out of 10 cats, and the winner is the name of our final round. Here's your first one. Top cause of arguments.
Stella.
Is it when men don't do as they're told?
Sorry, love?
Is it the many and varied inadequacies of women?
Oh, we've got the makings of a sitcom here.
Someone has to say it. Someone has to say it.
I deliberately said that to see if Sarah would disagree, thus proving my point.
No.
But she didn't bite, and I just look like a bit of a chauvinist.
Just
but I'm
a
wearing
bit.
The cardigan, which I think offsets it.
In your defence, John. In your defence, I don't think she understood it.
Is the argument thing, is it shopping? Because my boyfriend will only go in a shop with me if it sells shoes, because then there's definitely seats.
You know what I really like? I love going back to that shop that we went to first to buy that thing that you didn't like. That thing I said, get that, because I think that's right, and you went, no, let's try six or seven different, and you go back and they've gone, oh, it's different now, the designer's come in and changed the fucker.
The worst thing is she buys the blouse, she gets it home, she don't like it, and you have to bloody wear it.
I argue about stuff like, I had an argument recently about what point does a lager top become a shandy? As I said to the guy, I said, there's too much lemonade in there. You're in some kind of new zone here where it's not a shandy, but it's not a lager top either. And it really pisses me off. It really gets me angry. So now what I do is I do have it in kit form. So I have the beer and I have the lemonade and I have a swig of beer, a little bit of lemonade, and I'm... And then I get it just right. It's just how I like it. And they just won't learn.
Yeah, it's one of the big issues. That is the number one cause of argument.
Another one I really winds me up is the... Oh, God. It's the inconsistent spelling of poppadom. Excuse me, is it dumb... Dam, sometimes it's dom, it's with a U, it's A. I actually went to the Indian Embassy at 2 o'clock in the morning with four menus. And I was going, which one is right?
What do you argue about, Louis?
I'm not a confrontational person at all. No, I just make everything right with dance. So...
If we dropped you in Afghanistan...
Yep.
You start going, ooh.
Yeah.
The Taliban go, hold, what are we doing?
Oh, no. Exactly.
Wrong. Might be telly. Is it TV? Because when Sex and the City was on, I, like most men, pretended to hate it. That's what we do, because basically it's four attractive women talking about sex and that. And so we go, oh, what are you watching this rubbish for? What's this something good on? And you go, and she goes, oh, I'll turn it over. And you go, no, I'll just read my book. You carry on watching it.
You don't read books.
Give you a clue. It's something that no one wants to do.
Washing up.
Domestic chores.
Sean, you got it exactly. I'm going to give it to you.
Yeah. So we get a point.
Yes, the top cause of arguments is domestic chores. Of course, the best thing about a big, passionate argument is tumbling into bed together and lying in cold, grim silence until dawn.
That one's not a joke either, is it, love?
No.
Are you all right?
Has anyone got a T-shirt a little bit too small? Worst thing to discover when you wake up. Go on, sorry.
The worst thing to discover when you woke up, I find, is that you've just missed a junction.
Is the worst thing to wake up to footprints in the armrests of the dentist chair?
I can't understand how tall your dentist is if his feet are on the side. Surely that's his knees.
Louis, what we need is a demo.
Oh, no, you're gonna die. You're gonna die.
I'm gonna hold
my dentist. I can hold my dentist.
So, Jason, on the scale. It'd
be good if the one show started like that with Louis, you poking out between Louis and Jason.
Okay. Worst thing to discover. I know it's properly a horrific nightmare.
I know what
scenario.
It is. I know what it is. It's you wake up and you can see a zookeeper going.
I just like that.
I'll give you a clue. You might be in hospital, sort of halfway through something.
Halfway through an operation.
Sorry.
Halfway through an operation.
That's the right answer.
Yes.
Yes, the worst thing to discover when you wake up is that you're halfway through an operation, especially if you hear the words, when you say left, do you mean left as I'm looking at it? Well, that sound tells me it's the end of the round and the end of the show, which means the final scores are Sean, Johnny and Sarah have 4 points, Jason, Louis and John have one with 5 points. Sarah. Thanks to all our panellists, our wonderful studio audience, and to all of you for watching at home. That's it from us. Good night.
Russell Brand, Scandalous and live at the O2 at 11:25. Simon's on the pool next and pretty much cracks it until the lads show up on his date, the in-betweeners, on 4.